Well, it's been a few months since I did any real napping. Last thing I did was work on this guy. This core, the last one I took off, didn't go super well. You can see there's a big Hertzian cone there. Probably got in the way. The pocket's in the middle too. But we got some nice pieces off along the way. That's a nice spall. I love that bullseye. I don't have my big leather pad, so I'll have to make do with this. But I am out in nature this time. Finally doing some napping in the woods, out by myself. Nice and peaceful out here. First thing I'll do is clean up the earlier mistake. It's real messy in there. It's not gonna happen yet. Let's go down here. Gonna do something drastic on this back end. I'm hoping I can work from this kind of messed up face, get rid of the bad stuff, then take a few large flakes off, and then use this side as kind of the final, the end of the core, and then a biface itself later on. Yeah, I messed that up. More cones. Flatten that out a little bit more. think I'll try and take one here first. Get rid of that high spot, that bulge there. Then come back to this platform. Came back up a little farther than I hoped and rippled out a little bit, but that's okay, I can flatten that out. Fixed it up pretty nicely. I can use that as a small biface itself, or a nice tool flake. Go for it and get a big one down this face. A little thick, but I can attack the high spots from the ends. It'll be a short biface, but that cleaned up this area real nicely. Still bulges out here, that kind of bothers me, but that might allow me to take a nice flake either here or here. Maybe I'll just take one right down the center and I can have a real big biface that hopefully has a nice bullseye in the center. Yeah, maybe I'll do that. And then this flake can have all of this really cool patterning in the center. Cool patterning, but it also messes up the flow of energy. It's less predictable in there. Might be hard to do. There's a flake that tried to initiate and dip down real deep that kind of concerns me, but if I drive a big flake using right here as the platform, it can hopefully spread out and take this whole piece. Cool. That did what I wanted it to. It kind of overshot the end of the core there. That's okay. Gets rid of this high spot. Gets rid of some ripples down there. That is some very cool quartz in the middle of that. Let me give you a close-up of it. very nice. Let's see if I can take a big flake off there and another one there. And then try and have a biface with that in the center. Very cool stone. I love this stuff. I think I'll use this as a platform, try and take a big flake off this way, because this platform angle isn't quite right to take them down here. And I don't want to take too much off of this. I would have to really lower it down to get a good angle this way, so I'll take advantage of this and come here. First, let's clean this up a little. Came all the way down to there. Whoops. That was bad. Real bad. Shouldn't have tried a new hammerstone for that one. Should have just stuck with the slightly smaller one. At this point, I'm just trying to remove this back face in as many large flakes as I can, so I can retain the cool pattern in the final biface. Came off in two pieces, but that did nicely. It's a perfect scraper flake right there. Wow. That one's gonna need a close up. For sure. That went even better than I hoped for. That is a nice flake. Let's see these up close. All right, that's enough messing around with that one for now. Maybe I'll do a bit of antler direct before I move down to the indirect. These crystals, these quartz crystals are causing some concern, of course, but that was to be expected. That's what happens when you go for the pretty inside. Well, this is what that boulder turned into. We've got all the flakes and debris from today. We've got that final biface here in the middle, and some of the larger flakes that came off. Got a lot to work with. Some nice spalls for making bifaces. I can probably make 3 decent sized bifaces, a few smaller ones, and a few really small ones. Some of these flakes are good for making tools like scrapers, cutters, multi-tools. Maybe in the next video, I'll just finish bifacing down this one. Next, I'll do some direct percussion with antler. Maybe even move down to the indirect stage today. I just got a little bit of time left, but we'll see what I can do.